All right, I hope everybody's doing well. We're going to talk about the long-term use of the Harbor Freight solar panel. If you haven't seen the original video, click the link above. You'll notice that the pattern of the solar panel grids are different between the first video and this one. And that's only because we believe that this one here is a later production by maybe a month or two, but there's been no difference in output or anything like that. We just think it's either a factory or design change. But it's been about a year and a half. These things have been on the roof through snow, rain, blazing 100-degree temperatures in the summer, below zero in the winter. It's fallen off the roof during a storm. So we're gonna go in and look at like the edges and look at everything and what's wore and tore on it, and then go into an output video and see exactly if this thing is still putting out the rated 100 watts or what it's putting out. So we have a cable here just for reference. As you can see, this one has been out in the sun compared to this new cable. The older one is pinkish and a lighter matte black. This is deep red. This used to be deep red, just like that color, but the sun faded it. So that's really the major thing that happened out there, some sun fade on the glass itself. There's absolutely no damage, no cracks, no micro cracks. Everything looks good. All the solder joints, all the strips, everything looks amazing on here still. Even the plastic still looks good sitting out there. We're talking a year and a half, and the only thing that faded on sticking out is the cable. As far as all the metal, no rust would be expected. It's aluminum. We're going to turn around and take a look at the back now. But again, the face of the panel that's been getting beat on by the sun the whole time, perfect condition. All right, we're on the back side of the panel here. And as you can see, the sticker is all frayed up and everything on the corners. We noticed that one of the legs sticks out just like fine. This one became a little loose. Now we can probably tighten the screw up there, but that one falls back down. And the nuts got a little bit of rust on them. But that's expected. It's probably cheap steel. But again, the aluminum itself, just some scratches from where it fell down and slid around on the roof, because these aren't mounted. They're literally on the roof with just the legs open like that, up on the roof. The whole year and a half it's been like that. Super dirty. We don't clean the backside of it. So yeah. I mean, the panels has been really durable for us. So we'll get into the output video now and see what we got. Again, our oldest Harbor Freight panel, and why we think this is still a great deal, because it does come with legs. The only downside is the SAE connector that runs in between everything. But we're gonna get this set up on the power meter and see exactly what we're getting. All right, as you can see here in the top right corner where it says 93.66, that is the wattage of the solar panel right now, just standing on its own legs, angled at the sun. We have 135 amp hour battery here. It would take 9 hours at this rate. So this thing's already performing over what it states in the manual, because I believe the Harbor Freight manual is about 6.5 amps now for these things. But we're running it through an MPPT charge controller, so we expect a little bit higher of a boost. Now we're going to angle it towards the sun because it is getting towards winter. So we want to get the top of the panel closer to the sun. And we're raising it now. As you can see, the wattage is continuing to go up. We are at 100% efficiency now. Look at that, over 100 watts. This is why this is still the best solar panel, we think, that you can pick up readily available at a store. Because this is years, and sorry for the camera movement, I'm just trying to get it centered. This is years of having this thing through storms, rain, snow, everything you can think, and we're pumping out a consistent 100 watts. And this would be very easy to angle by putting a box or some bricks under it. And actually, that's probably what we'll go do now. We'll get a box and put it under there and see how much we can harvest this sun for. All right, and there it is, 100.42 watts. And we're charging at 7.5 amps. We'll just leave it here and let it charge. see how long it'll go for. It's about 11:30 in the morning right now. So not even high noon, and we're still pumping out 100 watts. What an excellent panel this has been.